Hey guys, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to show you how to import the character created for 3D Avatar into Blender 4.2.1 for the latest version today, 4.2.1. So, start from now, I'm going to show you all the step by step. Alright, in CC4 character created for, what you need to do is, once you already finished design a 3D Avatar, just click File, Export, FBX cloth character. Then choose Blender as the target tool preset. Turn on the setting. Then just export the mesh. Activate the install LOD. Merge the material. This is to make sure it is going to bake off the material texture to just become one single material. It will make your life easier later in Blender. Then, this setting, merge opacity to diffuse texture. Just take it to select it. Export. Okay. As demo, I will just put it on the desktop. Just right click, create. Folder model 01. The file name, I will just name this as model 01 as well. Then I click save. Now it already successfully exported. Just have a check. The FBX file is here. Next, just open your Blender 4.2.1, click the empty area, press A and press delete button, click file, import FBX from the desktop, model 01, double click to just import it, and wait for a while. Now it already successfully imported. Then click here to turn on the material texture. And then you can see the material texture is not set properly yet. Then so what you need to do is just click it and go to the material, scroll down. The render methods, you have to choose the detail. All right, once you already click it, just wait for a while, it is going to load the material and re-render it. Now you can see everything already rendered properly. So next, what you can do is just click the face and test all of the shape keys are here. For example, something related to eyes, this is somewhere here. This is just a random test. The ear, the nose. You can see. All of these are the facial expressions shape key. Then, click the skeleton. We test the skeleton. The armature. Just make it in front. The name. Next, we are going to test the mouth. The mouth open. So you should be able to find a jawbone. So just go to the post mode. You can just find out which one is the jawbone. Facial bone. All right. We try to test this to have a look. Yes, this is the jawbone. You can create the talking animations just by using the keyframe, by using this jawbone. Alright, for open mouth, no problem. We try the eyes. To test the eyes, I'm going to change the display of the bone to become stick. Then I click it. We try. Now you can see the eyeball can be rotated. up and down, same as the right eyes. You just need to manipulate the eyes bones. All right, then how about the body? We just have a random task. The hand, not this skeleton. It's another one. Just another side. Now you can see the hand bones is okay, the neck bone. So this 3D avatar that from CC4, Character Creator 4, is already imported into Blender and is ready for 3D animations. It included all of the facial expression shape key and also the full skeletons. You can perform the 3D animation, you can retarget with any humanoid 3D animations now. Everything work properly. Alright, that's all for today about my tutorials on how to import the Character Creator for the CC4 3D avatar into Blender 4.2.1 and to make it become a humanoid 3D avatar in Blender 4.2 and which is ready for the 3D animations. Alright, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. If you love my videos, tutorials and sharings, if you feel all these tutorials and sharings are very helpful to your 3D modeling, 3D animations and 3D game developing, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel and also turn on the mini bell and select all so that when next time I publish a new videos, tutorials or sharings, you receive a notification immediately. See you in my next video. Enjoy! Happy 3D modeling, 3D animations, and 3D game developing. See you!